Value This, Dr. Lori, and we are in Burlington County. Where are we? What are we doing here?
We're looking at all this. These are the treasure trove places.
Yes.
This is the place where you really find the bargains, the cool stuff, the stuff that's been, you know, packed away for all this time. So we're using these particular objects to identify how do you basically spot value.
Exactly.
So I'm going to teach you how do you spot value in things like that are commonplace. So like trunks and tables and
yes,
such.
You see a lot of trunks. Yep. In places, they're fascinating. You can use them as coffee tables. Are they worth anything?
A lot of people, yeah, they can be worth something. And, you know, when you look at these trunks, people are surprised to say, wow, you know, is that one authentic? Is that one really from, you know, trunks date all the way back. I mean, way back, sailors' trunks, trunks on ships, trunks that would actually be treasure trunks, you know, this kind of thing. So what we're looking at here are some from the early 1900s. And if you start to look at them and as you see them, you can see not only hardware on them that can be valuable, but actually the size of them. Some of them are used and repurposed for coffee tables or occasional tables in family rooms with a piece of glass on them.
Okay, what is a size that indicates some value, and what are the things you would look for?
Okay, bigger is better.
Okay.
I'm taking from someone who knows, right? So basically, I want you to have an understanding that the larger the trunk, of course, more that you can fit in it. Oftentimes, these trunks were the only things that people would come across to the New World in, right? Or these are the things that you oftentimes would see on sailing ships. The form is significantly important because not only do they have these nice leather straps and the nice hardware, but again, they actually will be the originating form for all of the trunks down the road. So you're going to see when you open up these trunks, trays that come out, you're going to see that they're going to have paper, sometimes newspaper of the era, on the inside like decoupage.
And if they don't have the tray is missing, that diminishes value.
It devalues it, yes.
Okay.
Anytime you don't have all the parts, it diminishes value, right?
And do you want a rounded top one versus a flat top?
Many people prefer the rounded top because of the look. The rounded top actually would be where you can actually place hats.
Oh.
And other things that are three-dimensional as opposed to smaller three-dimensional
okay.
pieces, but pieces that couldn't get, of course, smashed. So those were the reasonings for that. You know, if you think of Titanic, the great movie where Kate Winslet comes up the gangway
right.
and all of her trunks follow,
yes.
these are the types of things that people are looking for.
Okay. Are those metal straps, leather straps?
Okay,
what are
sometimes
those?
They're leather straps, and then as time goes on, they actually paint the straps on.
Oh.
There's no straps at all, but they're actually just painted on or printed on. Sometimes they use lithographic tin. Sometimes they use actual pigment, like they paint them on. Sometimes it is just a piece of what would be considered composition matter or cardboard, right?
What is a trunk that is not worth anything versus a trunk that has value?
Well, the trunks that we see here can be as low in value as $50, as high in value as $500 to $1,000.
Okay.
For one.
And
in good shape.
And what is it that you're looking at?
I'm looking for, I love it when they have the metal. I love it when they have the leather. I love it when they have the original hardware. A lot of these do, a lot of these don't. I even like those that are from the 19-teens and 1920s that are actually cardboard. Right? They're made of a pressed board. They have a good style to them as well, but they won't be worth as much because the materials are not as good. And speaking of materials, you want to think about any of these box pieces, whether it's a table or whether it's a storage box or an advertising piece that a foodstuff was shipped in. You want to look for good construction, dovetails. You want to look for, in fact, the type of materials that will say quality.
Even on these boxes that have food that looked like they were probably throwaway boxes at the time.
Right. Oh, people are collecting them and putting glass on top and making them tables.
Uh-huh.
With the popularity comes the price tag. People can bring up the value because people want them. They're desirable. Supply and demand.
How do you know if that's real? Because that looks to me like something that anybody could sort of just make up an old-looking piece.
Like this tray
that is not old.
That is new.
Trying to look old. And,
right.
and would it be possible to do that with the advertising food
sure.
boxes?
Sure. Sure. Okay. You get an old-fashioned stencil and you stencil the name on. Sure, you can do that. But the construction of it and also, you know, you can't really fake age. You see that age spot? You see this age spot? You can't fake it.
Okay.
After a while, that just happens. And you can see that as you look at these pieces. So look at the sides, which are going to be worn. They're not going to be straight. right? Because they're going to be worn over time. Look at what the oils on your hands will do over time on an object. You also will not see the bright, of course, aspect of the printing either on these pieces. So when it comes to trunks, when it comes to box structure in general, you want to look for those particular types of things. And the side will tell you a lot.
Okay, and real fast value on food boxes.
Oh, they could be $10 and they could be $150 to $400.
Okay.
Yeah, so remember, bigger the box and the more promotional and more recognizable. A Coca-Cola box is going to be worth more than, you know, Joe's Farmhouse.
Okay.
You know.
All right, Dr. Laurie, thank you so much. I love these trunks. I love these. It's like a treasure trove, a pirate's box. Thanks so much for all your information and thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on Value This with Dr. Laurie.